My name is Dr. Daniel DiMizio, and I am an assistant professor of medicine at Columbia University Medical Center. So vasculitis is an umbrella term that is used basically to classify a series of diseases that are characterized by inflammation of the blood vessels. And it encompasses several different diseases, and it affects people of varying ages, ranging from very young in childhood to the very old, up until 80s, 90s or older. It typically presents with systemic symptoms such as fevers, night sweats, but can also present with rashes affecting large portions of the body, including the lower extremities or the chest, often presenting with joint pain or other vast manifestations dependent upon which blood vessels are being involved in the disease. So the diagnosis of vasculitis can be really tricky, very challenging. Blood tests, imaging studies, and sometimes even biopsies, you know, taking a piece of a organ or skin to look at it under the microscope, is often required or imperative in the diagnosis of vasculitis. The goal of treating vasculitis ultimately is to bring the disease to a low disease state or remission state. The way that we treat it is through an induction phase followed by a maintenance phase. So typically we give patients very strong medications on the outset to quickly relieve their symptoms and bring their disease into that low disease state. And then following that, we have a maintenance stage where patients are on typically oral medications, sometimes intravenous medications, to basically keep that disease well controlled and hopefully in a remission state. We have a team of providers from various specialties within medicine, including neurology, dermatology, gastroenterology, pulmonology, to really take care of all of the symptoms that a patient with vasculitis might be experiencing, essentially providing an experience where patients really feel cared for and allow their providers to talk with one another, share information together, and really provide the multi-systemic, multidisciplinary care that the patients with vasculitis really do require.